Stop! Stop! Why don't you act like a young lady?
This is Mariah Valenzuela, a young Phoenix mom, a Phoenix police officer doing that to her face in a violent arrest, even though she committed no crime.
I don't think that I should be taking advantage and thrown around by a man like that and be okay. It's not okay. It's not acceptable.
Tonight, Mariah sitting down for an exclusive television interview.
And it comes as ABC 15 investigator Melissa Blazius uncovers the troubling history of the arresting officer accused of repeatedly crossing the line.
And we want to warn you, the video may not be appropriate for all viewers.
Phoenix police officer Michael McGillis pulled over 23-year-old Mariah Valenzuela for crossing over the center line before a left turn.
What I remember was him saying hi to me, asking for my ID.
What's your license?
But Officer McGillis would later tell investigators that Mariah was verbally non-compliant.
Put your hands behind your back.
Excuse me.
Put your hands behind your back.
No.
Put your hands behind your back. Stop.
As soon as he grabbed me, I just got really scared. It was dark. I knew it was just me and him.
Give me your arm, please.
You're hurting me.
Give me your arm.
And after she's cuffed, it's still not over.
Stop arguing! Why don't you act like a young lady?
This video became a national news item this summer as anti-police brutality protests swept across major cities. Mariah was initially charged with DUI and resisting arrest, but prosecutors later dropped the criminal charges.
So all this boils down to a traffic violation.
Yes.
Mariah filed a federal lawsuit last month.
You can't throw a 98-pound woman to the ground and then press your weight on top of her. I think to anybody who watches that video, it's pretty clear that Officer McGillis should have known that what he was doing was wrong.
Mariah's lawyer claims Officer McGillis violated her civil rights by unlawfully arresting her and using excessive force, and that Phoenix police have created a culture of impunity that encourages officers to use excessive force. You're about to see why.
For months now, the ABC 15 investigators have been delving into Officer McGillis's history, finding multiple complaints from people who say he used foul language or unnecessary force on traffic stops.
According to public records obtained by ABC 15, since 2014, the Phoenix Police Department internally investigated McGillis 12 times, including 8 citizen complaints.
It was just very upsetting to hear that he's up to the same thing, doing the same thing.
This woman who asked us to conceal her identity because she's still afraid says she has these photos of bruises, and she says Officer McGillis caused them in 2014 after she was arrested for DUI.
When we were inside the trailer, he slammed my body against the wall and lifted me up from the floor by my neck. That was really scary. And I think the worst part was when he threw me out of the trailer.
Back then, Phoenix police found no evidence of misconduct, in part due to the absence of date stamps on these photos. Another driver videotaped Officer McGillis on a late night traffic stop.
I don't want to talk.
Good. We're going to do some roadside tests.
So you're now aggravating things to make it seem like I've done something, and I have not done a thing.
Well, what I have seen
not done a thing
can potentially be suspect for impaired driving.
This is you escalating.
This man says McGillis intimidated him, and he asked us not to use his name or face because he committed no crime at the time and was let go with a rude warning.
Maybe stop driving on autopilot.
Whoa. Oh, sorry. Are you serious?
The driver hears McGillis and another officer talk about him as they walked away.
And I'm being an a-hole?
After that inappropriate remark in November 2019, Phoenix police said McGillis received coaching or training. He got the same non-punishment, coaching or training, when he cursed out a different driver a year earlier. And McGillis was counseled again by a supervisor. This would be the third time, 1 week before Mariah's arrest. That was because an alert had been issued in Phoenix Police's early intervention system, which is designed to track officers at risk for misbehavior.
It seems like the city of Phoenix had plenty of notice that Officer McGillis was a problem officer. but nothing was done.
My hair is wet of blood.
And after a bleeding and crying Mariah claimed Officer McGillis wronged her and hurt her, supervisors responded like this.
And then we'll do the use of force, just the CYA, everybody.
ABC 15 asked Phoenix police about Officer McGillis' behavior towards Mariah and other drivers. A Phoenix police spokeswoman replied, traffic stops are all unique, and the officers use their training, experience, and judgment to determine the appropriate course of action when a person refuses to give the officer the information they are required to provide. She added, in the past 5 years, McGillis never had a sustained accusation of misconduct, as defined by their policies. Supervisors also give glowing annual reviews for McGillis's large number of DUI arrests, his dedication, and the genuine, caring attitude you display with the subjects you deal with on a nightly basis.
It's like a bad apple, and they wanted to stick up for him, so that's very scary.
Even after all that happened, Mariah Valenzuela says she doesn't want Officer McGillis fired necessarily, but she does want someone to intervene to help him find an outlet so he learns to never cross the line again. I'm investigator Melissa Blasius, ABC 15, Arizona.
Michael McGillis is Phoenix PD's most senior DUI motorcycle officer, and he does remain on patrol duty.